Mr. True, in this video, we're going to do two examples based off the same story, dealing with related rates. This is the third video in our series involving related rates. We've done a video that works with related rates when you're discussing some area and volume. We did a second video where we had some problems dealing with right triangles, and sometimes it was Pythagorean theorem, sometimes it could have involved a trigonometric function. Potentially those kind of questions may deal with area as well. In our third video, we're going to be looking at, well, I'm kind of giving it away here, the solution or how we're going to approach this problem. It's going to be dealing with similar figures. So what do we have here? We have a woman 5 feet tall, walks at a rate of 4 feet per second away from a light, which is 13 feet above the ground. Very likely that your textbook, your calculus book, has a question similar to this somewhere in the homework. When she is 12 feet from the base of the light, at what rate is the tip of her shadow moving away from that light? Because she's walking away from it. And we're going to do a part B, which is going to be discussing the rate of change for her actual shadow. Okay, so anytime you're dealing with a problem that involves geometry, you should allow yourself to actually see the geometry, the math that is going on. So we're going to go ahead and we'll put the drawing right here and hopefully have it big enough that you can see. We've got a light pole, basically. And at the top of this light pole, there is a light, and it is casting light everywhere, but we're going to be focused on that light interacting with this woman walking away from the light. This light is 13 feet above the ground, so we're going to put a 13 over here, a little dash mark for feet, except now in calculus we might think that is a prime symbol or a derivative. Of course, we're not going to take the derivative of a constant. And then we have this young lady here, 5 feet tall, walking away from the light, and her shadow, the tip of the shadow down here, of course, on the ground. Okay, now we're going to have to use some variables, obviously. Let's see what's going on. When she is 12 feet from the base of the light, so when she's 12 feet from the base of the light, so let's go ahead and put a W here for the distance the woman is away from the light. The 13 is the number, but it's a value that's not going to change within the problem, so I'm going to go ahead and leave that 15, that 13 there. Same with the 5, her height is not going to change, but the distance that she is away from the light certainly is. So we're being told that we have, for part A, we're going to work with W, which is equal to 12 feet. Just writing down all the information given and asked for. We may or may not use everything. She's walking away at a rate of 4 feet per second. So maybe we're doing the W for the walking distance or the woman, but she's doing 4 feet per second. Feet per second is an expression of, and let you know that this is a rate, besides the word rate, but we have 4 feet per second. Four is not a measurement of length. It is a measurement of movement, specifically, I guess we could say, velocity. Since she's moving to the right, that velocity would be positive, at least the way I have this drawing set up, or maybe can consider it her speed. But a rate of change is slope, and in calculus, of course, what gives a slope? Derivatives. So we needed some kind of derivative notation to identify and label this 4 with. If W is the distance she is away from the lamp, and at some specific moment in time, we're going to be interested in that specific length being 12 feet as that length increases, dW over dt is equal to 4 feet per second. Okay, so again, repeating myself, but rate, feet per second, a unit of measure of rate. Rate means slope. Slope in calculus is going to come from a derivative. Thus, we have a derivative type notation to go along with that value of 4. Okay, when she's 12 feet from the base of the light, at what rate is the tip of the shadow moving? Okay, now the tip of the shadow, we're going to be talking about her moving away from the light. So there's two influences on where the end of the shadow is at, how far she is away from the light, and how far she's moving. So this point is going to be moving as she moves. So we're not measuring the distance of the tip of the shadow to the woman. That's not in the wording of part A. It's just the tip of the shadow moving like sort of ground speed, if you will. Well, the fixed measurement or item that's in this picture is not the woman walking, it's the light pole. So we need a variable here that is going to mark the distance between the light and the tip of the shadow. So we're going to mark that distance off with the variable of x. Okay, so, and we have two, we're going to assume that the light pole is installed correctly and it's perpendicular to the ground, or it's plumb, and of course the woman is standing upright. And we see that we have a problem dealing with right triangles. So maybe we could, you know, we might have, like in previous problems, be working with Pythagorean theorem, maybe SOHCAHTOA, where we have the sine of theta is equal to opposite over adjacent, but we never work with the length of the hypotenuse of either one of these triangles. You see, this is kind of a unique problem. Up until this point in your calculus homework, and you, when you were dealing with right triangles, you were probably actually only dealing with one right triangle per problem, if you will. And in this question, we actually have two. We have a right triangle that is defined by the woman, and we have another right triangle that is defined by the light. So actually, and you can, with maybe some hypotenuse leg or angle-angle postulate from geometry, identify and realize that these two triangles are similar. These two triangles both have a right angle. These two triangles are both sharing this angle down here, basically at the tip of the shadow. So by the angle-angle postulate, these two triangles are similar, and that is how we're going to attack this problem. We have two right triangles interacting and changing size as this woman walks away from the light. And nowhere in our problem is there any discussion about any kind of angles, so it's not gonna be involving trig. So, for the triangle defined by the height of the woman, we have height of 5 over, over the base. Well, if the entire length from the light to the tip of the shadow is equal to the measurement of x, let's just arbitrarily say maybe this is 20 feet, and she has moved some measurement away from the light, maybe 5 feet, you would just subtract those numbers, right? This length here is going to be equal to x, the entire length of the base of this triangle, minus w. So we have her height with the length of the base, aka the length of her shadow, which is going to be x minus w, is going to be equal to the height of the larger triangle, 13. Try that again, 13, over the length of the entire base of that larger, similar, in this case, right triangle. So we have 13 over x. Okay, so we got a couple of fractions equal to each other now, set up with those equal ratios that we used to set up in geometry for similar figures. The question gives us a rate of change for w, the distance between her and the light, and it's asking for, and I didn't actually label that, did I? At what rate is the tip of the shadow moving? The shadow's tip is x feet away from the light. It's going to be moving away from the light as she walks away from the light, so we're being asked to find dx dt. Okay. I don't want to take the derivative of both sides of this equation using the quotient rule, so let's rewrite this in a format that's going to be easier to work with. We're going to cross multiply basically and have 5x is equal to 13 times x minus w. Of course, we can see that we have a variable of x on each side, and this won't be very hard to clean up a little bit. Let's distribute both the 13 through the parentheses on the right-hand side and have 5x is equal to 13x minus 13w. We're going to subtract, let's do this. Let's have some positive coefficients instead of negative ones. We're going to add both sides by 13w and subtract both sides by 5x, giving us 13w is equal to 13 minus 5 is going to be 8x. And remembering that we're looking for the rate of change of x over time, we're going to divide both sides by 8 and have 13, okay, we're going to have 13 over 8w is equal to x. So now we're going to bring the motion into the problem, because right now we don't have any movement because we don't have any derivatives. So we're going to take the derivative of both sides with respect to time, and we're going to have 13 over 8, and the derivative of w with respect to t is just going to be dw over dt. And on the right-hand side, we have the derivative of x with respect to time. And that's what we're being asked to find. We're being asked to find, and I'm running out of room here, the derivative of x with respect to time when she is 12 feet from the base of the light. Let's not forget that we marked that distance between the light and this woman as variable w. So we're going to be looking for the derivative of x with respect to t when w is equal to 12. This derivative is asking for the rate of change of the woman walking. It actually only asks for dw dt, so this is another unique situation or characteristic of this problem, in your related rates homework. One, it's probably the first time you're seeing two similar figures interacting at the same time. And curiously here, we're told to find the rate of change for the tip of her shadow, how fast is it moving, basically, when she's 12 feet from the light, w is equal to 12, but actually the derivative doesn't ever ask for any specific value of w. The rate at which the tip is moving is only dependent on how fast this person is walking. So that was equal to 4 feet per second. And of course, the 4 is going to cancel with the 8, giving us a division of 2. And our final answer is that the tip of her shadow is moving at 13 over 2 feet per second. And let's just do a quick double check. Da-da! And even though we didn't actually need to use the specific distance of w, let's make sure that we include that in that derivative notation, because usually these rates of change in related rate problems are going to be unique to a certain fixed value. So you should always use that notation just to make sure that you're good for all of your other problems. Now part B coming up right now. So for part B, when she's 12 feet from the base of the light, at what rate is the length of her shadow changing? So now we're not concerned about how quickly the tip of her shadow is just moving in relation to the ground, if you will, the distance, say, between the tip of her shadow and the light, but actually the rate of change for the length of the shadow. Well, in this diagram, what variable or expression is describing the length of the shadow? Clean it up a little bit. We have 13 for the height of the light pole. We have 5 feet for the height of this woman. We have x, which is the distance between the tip of the shadow and the light pole. And we have w, which is how far the person is, the woman is, away from the light. Oh, x minus w is the length of the shadow. And if we want the rate of change for the length of her shadow, we need the derivative with respect to time of the length of the shadow, which is x minus w. And it's really important that you be able to look at what the question says, and from that language understand what you're looking for. What is that sort of calculus symbol that goes along with that wording to tell you or give you direction of how to do the problem? Because that's when you're dealing with word problems, you can't be given just a set of like five steps and every question will work out this way. You have to read the story because sometimes, like you've realized hopefully, you might be dealing with area or volume or distance between a point and the origin or any kind of scenario. Related rate problems, you know, that's the fun and the challenging part of these questions. So if the rate of change for the shadow, oh, that's x minus w, go back to your original formula that you came up with that dealt with the similar figures that involved or that are involved in this problem and isolate the variable or the expression describing the length of the shadow and then take the derivative of it. So we're going to have that 5 over x minus w is equal to 13 over x. We're going to cross multiply. I'm kind of just talking my way through this. We're going to start off here with the second line. I just wanted you to know where this was coming from. So here we go to divide both sides by 13 to isolate the expression describing the length of the shadow, and we have x minus w is equal to 5 thirteenths x. Now let's bring in the derivative notation since that's what we're being asked for, and I don't know why I moved that so close to put that so close together. And we have the derivative with respect to time of x minus w is equal to 5 thirteenths. That's the constant coefficient, if you will, and we're just taking the derivative of x with respect to t. So we have 5 thirteenths dx dt. So the rate of change for the shadow length is only dependent on the rate of change or the sort of speed, if you will, that the tip of the shadow is moving. Again, we have a derivative that's not asking for the specific length that this person is, this woman is, away from the light pole. So it's very interesting in that sense. And I'm just don't like the way I'm organizing this, I apologize, but the derivative with respect to time of x minus w, when, even though we're not being asked to use it, we're not being asked by the derivative to use this or plug in the value, but when w is equal to 12 is equal to 5 thirteenths times dx dt, which we just found in part A, was equal to 13 over 2 feet per second. The 13s cancel out and we have 5 over 2 feet per second. And let me just double check. Excellent. That is specific for when w is equal to 12, except the derivative never asks us for the specific value of w. So really, as long as this person keeps walking at the, 4 feet per second, their shadow is going to change by 5 halves feet per second, or 2.5 feet per second. I'm Mr. Tarrou. Go do your homework.